Hi, this is Dr. Subhatra. In today's session, I am going to discuss about one of the mineral admixtures, GGBFS, that is the ground granulated blast furnace slag. It is a non-metallic product which consists essentially of silicates and aluminates of calcium and other bases. The molten slag is rapidly chilled by quenching in water to form a glassy, sand-like granulated material. The granulated material, when further ground to less than 45 micron, will have a specific surface of about 400 to 600 meter square per kg. The chemical composition of the blast furnace slag is just similar to that of the cement clinker. The performance of the slag mainly depends upon the chemical composition, glass content, and fineness in grinding. In India, it produced about 7.8 million tons of blast furnace slag. All the blast furnace slags are granulated by quenching the molten slag by high power water jet, making 100% glassy slag granules of about 0.4 mm in size. So, this is a byproduct of the extraction of iron from iron ore. Coke and limestones are added as a fluxes inside the blast furnace. Impurities in iron ore combine with the lime and rise up to the surface of the blast furnace, while the molten iron, which is heavier, stays at the bottom. This can be shown in the diagram also. In the present day scenario, slag is almost used in every country in varying temperatures also. The reactivity depends upon the rate of cooling. Increasing the order of reactivity, the cooling process may be ranked as low cooling or rapid cooling or dipping in water, that is quenching. Almost the mineral admixtures, slag possesses the highest specific gravity. Among all the mineral admixtures, it possesses the highest specific gravity, around 2.8 to 3. Because it is a processed material and fineness is controlled at any desired degree. It has a wide range of applications since it is finer than the cement particles. So this picture shows how the GGBFS is obtained. The blast furnace slag is mainly used in India for the manufacturing slag cement. There are two methods for making the blast furnace slag cement. In the first method, the blast furnace slag is interground with the cement clinker along with the gypsum. In the second method, the blast furnace slag is separately ground and then mixed with the cement. So, in this process, ore, that is the iron ore, coke, limestone, they all are combined together and placed in the furnace. At the initial stage, dehydration and decarbonation is taking place at the smaller diameter portion. And after that, reduction of the iron ore is taking place and it is getting converted to iron oxide, FeO. Then, at this place, at the larger diameter portion, this iron oxide is getting reduced to iron. After that, beneath that, slag is formed. This slag formed is collected at the bottom. And the gas which is obtained is moving to the top and it is released outside. So, the bottom portion, what we are collecting is called as the slag. So the different types of slags are air-cooled slag. Second one is the expanded or foamed slag. From the name itself, we can see that this air-cooled slag is a low reactive slag. It is like an aggregate. The strength and toughness makes it as a suitable material. Therefore, we can use it as a rails and railway ballast also. I mean roads and railway ballast also. Then the second type is expanded or foamed slag. It is a low reactive slag which is formed by means of foamed air. So it becomes a lightweight material. It can be used as a lightweight aggregate and therefore used for thermal insulation. Then the next type is a granulated one. This is highly reactive. The first two are the low reactive slag, air cooled slag and expanded slag. Here the granulated is a highly reactive slag which is usually quenched. The hardened material is then ground to a finer, similar to that of the cement. So we are naming it as a ground granulated blast furnace slag. It is quenched, that hardened material is ground to a finer material. Thus, the name has arrived as ground granulated blast furnace slag. Granulated in ground, it is grind to a fine powder. Then the fourth type is the pelletized slag. The reactivity is as similar to the third type, that is a granulated slag. But the process of pelletization is a complex one. What are the factors that determine the cementitious property? Some factors they have given. One is the amount of CaO, calcium oxide. When the calcium oxide is more, the cementitious property of the slag will be more. Okay. When the reactivity of CaO is more, the slag reaction will also be more. When the alkali content is higher, then the system will be more reactive. When the glassy SiO2 is there, it will be the hydration process will be more. The higher finer particles, if it is there, faster reaction will be there. The slag hydration also depends upon the higher temperature. So GGBFS is a mineral admixture with both cementitious and pozzolanic property. Hence, in many of the codes, this GGBFS is referred to as a hydraulic cement also. As they are mentioning it as a hydraulic cement, we need some activator to hydrate that slag. Some of the activators are alkali activation, sulfate activation, mixer activations are there. Some of the alkali activators are caustic soda, sodium carbonate, sodium silicate. Sulfate activations are gypsum, hemihydrate, anhydrate and passport gypsums are there. Mixer activation means both alkali activation and sulfate activation. You can use it as a combined way. What are the effects of this GGBFS on fresh and hardened concrete? It apart from delaying the initial setting time, slag will not much more activate the or alter the fresh concrete properties. The workability is almost similar to the Portland concrete or the plain concrete. It will be at the same rate. The rate of strength gain is slow. But this delay increases with the increase in replacement. So if you are replacing 100% GGBFS by two cement means, the increase in strength will get delayed. The ultimate strength, the later stage strength will get improved. Durability can also be improved by means of slag. Hence, slag is an ideal mixer for marine concrete because it is resistant to chemical attack and also the corrosion. This GGBFS concrete is reported to have a higher carbonation rate when compared to the ordinary PC concrete. So therefore, we have studied about what are the effects of GGBFS on the fresh and hardened concrete properties, how to activate this slag, and what is the hydration process, what are the factors that determine the cementitious properties of slag, what are the different types of slags, air-cooled slag, expanded or foam slag, granulated and pelletized slag. In this, granulated is our type. Then how this GGBFS is produced. Okay, thank you.